Good evening again. This time it's actually evening, not morning, to be able to talk. Last night I got a chance to be able to talk to everybody right after the impeachment time, but it was 2 some odd in the morning. Last night it is only 10:20 tonight. We ended the floor time for the impeachment about 35 minutes ago now. I left out from the Capitol, made my way back over, back to my office. Started at 1 o'clock today and then ended around 9:40 tonight. It's a long day for us, and there's a lot going on, obviously, but it's also a really long day for the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court. He finished up last night, same time obviously all of us did, around 2 a.m., and then he had oral arguments this morning. Now, I had lots of meetings in my office this morning as well, but Chief Justice of the Supreme Court had oral arguments in the Supreme Court this morning until late morning, and then he left there to be able to get over to the Senate, then to be able to start that proceeding at 1 o'clock. In fact, there's a major religious liberty case that is a case out of Montana that was actually in the Supreme Court this morning. So he's definitely had a busy day as well. I started the day at 1 o'clock. We had lunch together as a conference. All the Democrats met, all the Republicans met, and had lunch together, then started the hearing. And today was the first day of the House managers presenting their case on the president. Yesterday, all day long, was 11 different amendments on rules and trying to be able to set up the procedure. All that is set. So today actually began the trial. Both the House and the White House were able to provide additional motions all this morning, but neither one of them chose to do additional motions this morning. We jumped straight into the trial. Now, the House managers will have 3 full days, up to 24 hours. They don't have to use all that, but they have up to 24 hours over 3 days to be able to make their case. They went from 1 until 9:40 today. They'll be able to do that again tomorrow and the next day if they choose to be able to do those 3 long days to be able to do it. And then after that, then the White House will be able to give the other point of view. In fact, that'll be the first time then the White House will actually be able to give their perspective. Obviously, they didn't have the opportunity to be able to do that in the House. They'll be able to do that. It looks like Saturday, if the House managers end on Thursday night, tomorrow night, or midday on Friday, they may be able to start on Friday a little bit. We'll just have to see what that timing looks like. But it's up to the House managers at this point how long that they actually go. Lots of interesting things. We've had some comments about people that are watching the hearing, getting a chance to be able to see what's happening. We've had some folks that have been fascinated about water or milk on the desk. That is a very old Senate tradition. You can either have water or milk at your desk. That's it. You can't bring soft drinks, can't bring tea in, can't bring coffee in. That's a long-standing tradition in the Senate, water or milk. And you can, in water, have sparkling water or still now. So that's it on the floor to be able to bring something else in. I've also been kind of amazed in hearing some things on the floor and just some of the dialogue from the House managers and from the White House, just some of the terms. Pat Cipollone is his name, and I've heard his name pronounced untold different ways, but it is Cipollone. You actually pronounce the E at the end, but it's Cipollone, Cipollone, all kinds of different ways have been said. Cipollone. And then the other funny thing to me is watching both sides, but especially obviously the House managers today and yesterday talking about Kyiv or Kiev. That's obviously the capital of Ukraine, but it is pronounced Kiev, like chicken Kiev, I guess, or Kyiv. The difference of that is the Russian pronunciation for that capital city is Kiev. The Ukrainian pronunciation of that city is Kyiv. And the House managers have been kind of funny. Some of the managers are pronouncing Kyiv, some of them pronounce it Kiev. And so it's just, I don't know, it's just been funny to me while I'm getting a chance to be able to walk through all of it. Today, the House managers walk through the timeline. If you had the opportunity to be able to be there all day long, starting with Adam Schiff, who actually walked the timeline. He spent 2.5 hours at the beginning speaking and walking through the timeline of how he sees the events over the last several months. Leading up until the impeachment actually in the House of Representatives and sending it over to the Senate. Then through the middle part of the day, there was a lot of conversation, which I thought was a little unusual because it really looked more like preference than it did like impeachment. For instance, there was a lot of talk about the president fired an ambassador in Ukraine, which the every single ambassador everywhere in the world works for the pleasure of the president. Every president releases ambassadors. There was a lot of emphasis on there was some secret reason why the president wanted to be able to release this ambassador, and they tried to be able to create a motivation for that. Didn't have a lot of facts and information on that, but they tried to weave that in the story. But it's really not an impeachable offense to be able to release an ambassador. There was also a lot of talk about that the president didn't follow the advice of staff on the National Security Council, or didn't follow the advice of the State Department. Or there was a lot of talk about there are these professionals that had written talking points, and the president didn't use those talking points. The president can choose to do whatever it may be. All of those people under him all work for him. He doesn't have to take their advice on it. And there are some folks that love the fact that the president is his own man. And clearly the White House managers today were furious that the president is his own man. They want him to be more consistent with previous presidents and want him to be like others that just follow the advice of staff, or that staff hand them what to say and they just say that. So that was a lot of the middle part of the day. Then towards the end of the day, it went back to the timeline again of all the different events that have happened, including Adam Schiff wrapping up the day with a faster version of his timeline than he did one more time. Most of the videos that we saw, the testimony, we actually saw three times today as they went through the day. So I was a little surprised by that, because I expected them to present different pieces all day long, but instead literally did the same stories, same videos, same testimony, three times at different times. And I don't know if they were doing that, saying people will watch different parts of it in the different parts of the day, so we're going to say the same thing three times over the course of the day, or if there's some other reason that they were doing that strategically. Obviously, they can create their own plan as they go through it. The way that I'm actually flowing through the argument is I've taken a notebook with me, and I'm actually flowing through the argument of each speaker as they go through, writing down key notes. I'm writing my own thoughts down in that process. I'm also writing a list of questions. I have a lot of questions for the White House attorneys when they step up and start making their case and give the other side of the story. So I'm keeping a long list of questions that I think they should be able to answer. If they don't answer, then I'm going to submit some of those questions in writing, because we'll have 16 hours of question time where any senator can ask a question of either side. And I think there's some reasonable questions that the House managers are bringing up at this point that the White House should be able to answer and should be able to give a response to. So I'm going through those, writing down both the argument, writing down my thoughts on it, and then also writing down my questions in preparation for that time as well. It's been interesting. I've had folks that have called into the office today, and I've not had a time to go through all the calls, but about 285 calls yesterday into the office while during that 13 hours that we were in the trial time. I'm still working my way through some of those, got through some of those this morning, but didn't finish all of those. But as folks are calling in, they're either saying you should have witnesses, shouldn't have witnesses, you should get this whole thing done as fast as possible, or you should stretch this out. A lot of response, obviously, on the amendments that were brought by House managers yesterday. They brought 11 different amendments asking for different investigations, different documents. We tried to be able to take a quick look at how long it would take if the House managers, if those 11 amendments were accepted, how long would this trial go on? And we're estimating somewhere around midsummer that the trial would still be going on based on the different requests that they have made of what they didn't do in the House, but they want the Senate to do now. So they had to move really, really urgently in the House, was the statement. We have to go really fast, 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 because the president, in their perspective, is a threat and he could be reelected. And so we need to get him out as fast as possible. But the request they're making of the Senate and the number of documents they're demanding the Senate to go chase will literally take us months to be able to gather. And they keep saying it'll be really fast, it'll be really fast. But we actually met with some legal counsel today to be able to talk through, okay, exactly what would it take to be able to get what their requests are when those requests up again. And it is a lot of time. We're talking months and months and months of time to be able to gather the different documents and testimony and such. So we're trying to take a look at all that, because the decision is going to be made sometime next week on what additional evidence, if we choose, if the House is not finished making this case, or if the White House is not able to respond, or what other testimony will be required in the process as we go through. So that's kind of how I'm walking through this process. I'm sure you're watching it on your own. There are folks that are writing in on email, or that are calling our office to be able to ask their own questions. We'll try to get as much information as we can up on the website to be able to walk through it and to be able to give the feedback. We've got another full day of listening to the House tomorrow, and the House managers to be able to continue to make their case. Their statement is they're going to focus on constitutional issues and law issues. I don't know what all that means at this point for what they're planning to do. I would assume it is something similar to what they did in their last hearing when they had constitutional law folks in their last hearing in the judiciary before they sent it over to us. They'll kind of wrap up that way, and then we'll see if they bring additional information on Friday. Starts at 1 o'clock Eastern time, noon in the center of the world in Oklahoma. And so a good chance to be able to tune in, be able to track it. Again, let us know if we can help in any way possible to be able to get your feedback in the days ahead.